Night of embattled Republican Congressman George Santos under fire for telling a long list of lies to voters, dodging questions from Armanu Raju, specifically refusing to say why, among many other lies, he falsely claimed to be a member of the Baruch College volleyball team. Here's Santos's response.
Why did you lie about being on a volleyball team?
You're lying to the American people. When you stop lying in your bad reporting, I'll start talking.
So wait, you actually were on a volleyball team? Is that right? In college, in Baruch College?
Really,
is that true?
This is Santos' ex-boyfriend is speaking to OutFront for his first television interview in an OutFront exclusive. Pedro Villarva shared this photo with us of him celebrating Christmas with Santos and other loved ones in 2014. He told me that Santos went by the name Anthony DeVolder when they dated. They lived together for about a year, and Villarva says he repeatedly turned down Santos's proposals to get engaged. Pedro joins me now from Brazil. And Pedro, I very much appreciate your time, and I know that your deciding to speak out was a very careful decision. Does this George Santos, the one that we are now all seeing, sound like the man that you dated and lived with?
No, not at all. Completely different person.
How so?
It's just, at the beginning of the relationship, he was fine. He was so sweet, caring. He showed that he actually cared and all. But later on, like, when I started finding out the lies, I thought that was it. That it was my phone that he stole, that he pawned it, that I believe. The jewelry as well from our friend that used to live with us. And so, the tickets to Hawaii that he had purchased for us to go, where he was planning to be proposing for the third time as well. But the engagement never happened, nothing like that.
You know, I know you say Santos repeatedly asked you to get engaged before you broke up. And he appears, Pedro, to reference you in an Instagram post that you shared with us from 2015. He writes, "This is my family that I managed to screw up. I will not give up. I will fight till the end. I love you, PV. I miss you." Now, Pedro, you were 18 and Santos was 26 when you met him. When did you know that you couldn't trust him?
Towards the end of the relationship, I started finding out about the lies in December, and then it went on until February. And then that's when I broke up with him, and then I went on my way. But then later on, we still had contact with each other because he didn't, I found out about the lies, but we still kept in contact with each other. Just saying oh, how are you? How's your mom and stuff? Because when I found out that she was sick, I still cared for her. And then I went to visit her a couple of times later on. But then when I found out about the other stuff, I was like, what a psycho.
You know, I want to share a picture of you that you shared with us of you and his mother. You say you were close. And besides, he said she was a survivor of the 9/11 terror attacks, right? He also claimed she was an executive at Citigroup. She was a part of many of his lies. There you are with her. This is a picture you shared with us. Did she ever discuss these lies with you? Did she know any of this?
No, I never. No 9/11, no Citigroup, nothing like that. From when I was with them, I never saw her going to work at Citigroup or anything. And they never mentioned anything about 9/11, even because I was born on 9/11. And if I say, if they knew that I was born on 9/11, I think they were going to reference that and say something about it, but never heard anything about it.
I want to play George Santos, what we've all now heard, Pedro, explaining who he is in his own words over the years.
My grandparents survived the Holocaust.
I'm a Latino Jew.
My mom was a 9/11 survivor.
They sent me to a good prep school, which was Harrisman Prep in the Bronx.
I actually went to school on a volleyball scholarship. When I was in Baruch, we were the number one volleyball.
Did you graduate?
But I put myself through college and got an MBA from NYU.
I also founded my own nonprofit organization
prior to running, I decided to close it. It was an animal rescue. We had a great organization. We were able to save animals, dogs, cats, horses.
I've lived an honest life. I've never been accused, sued of any bad doing.
I do want to note, of course, he was charged with embezzlement, so he has obviously been accused of bad doing. But, you know, Pedro, the point is some of these lies were so minor and yet so specific. I mean, the volleyball one, right? Not just saying that he played volleyball, but he had a scholarship, that he slayed teams from Harvard and Yale, that he was the smallest player on the team, that he needed to get two knee replacements. I mean, you know, he went deep with the lies. Why does he do this?
I don't know. I think he's just out of his mind, and one lie led to the other, and now that everybody found out, like, they're finding out, like, the little stuff as well. I just think that he should not be in Congress. And oh my God, it was so many things that I found out afterwards as well, things that I did not know, because I still believe that he actually went to Baruch College, like he used to say. I already knew about the Citigroup that he said that he used to work, and like the investments and such. So I already knew that those were lies, because I never saw him working, actually. But then the other stuff, like the stuff about the pets, he actually did used to say about the organization, about FUPU as well, that he used to do like... there was another person that also had a pet organization, so they used to have like a little picky fight with each other as well. So, but then I never saw anything going towards it, like charity stuff. When we were together, he never used to do anything towards that. So it was.
So Pedro, you know, what do you say? Are you surprised he's now a member of Congress? I mean, was that an ambition that he had?
He always what he always looked for was fame and power. That's all he cared about, and he got it. He got the fame of the lies, and he got the power that he's in Congress now. But it's he shouldn't be there.
Well, the story has gotten so big, right? Everyone is paying attention to it. You know, he's being spoofed by late night shows and other comedians. Here's a clip from this weekend, Saturday Night Live. I don't know if you saw it, but I'll play it for you, Pedro.
You lied about your mom dying in 9/11?
I think I said 7/11.
No. No, you even lied about being Jewish.
No, I said I was Jewish.
George, people need to know who you are.
Okay, well, I am George Santos, Miss DeValder, if you're nasty. I graduated on a volleyball scholarship from Baruch Atah Adonai University.
I see you laughing. People are laughing. But obviously, you know, this is serious stuff. I mean, do you think that he'll ever resign?
I don't think so. His ego is too big and too high. He's not going to resign. If they don't find out something to get him off, he's not going to do it. That's for sure.
All right. Well, Pedro, I appreciate your time. Thank you very, very much.
I appreciate your time.